Hi everyone, welcome to another video where we will go through some lists worth knowing about and worth sharing to family or friends. Today, we look at some tips that you can use when faced by various disasters. Before we proceed, please like, share, and comment on the video, telling us a good, practical tip to surviving any life-threatening disasters. Also, subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for more related videos. Let's dive in. What to do when faced by an attacker? Don't know martial arts? Basic self-defense? The better question would be, do you even need to learn martial arts or carry pepper spray with you to stay safe from attackers? Because there are simpler ways to keep you and your company safe. When someone approaches you to assault you, stomp on top of their foot as hard as you can. It's fast, simple, and all you need to do is to think fast and concentrate your force onto the foot that you're stomping on. That way, the attacker is left debilitated from the pain and possibly broken foot bones, and will not be able to get to you or your company. Next, what to do during an earthquake? Earthquakes are severely damaging in any parts of the world suffering it, and it will help a lot to know basic safety techniques when you're getting trapped in earthquake debris. Protect your upper torso as you would need your breathing organs intact. Take off your shirt and wrap your face in it in order to not inhale the dust that came with the debris. Slowly make your way out of the debris and into a safe place. What about lightning storms? Lightning is scary and most people have a phobia with lightning, which is a pretty good reason. If you're caught in the middle of a lightning storm, duck. Put your hands around your head covering your ears, or you can bring your head down to your knees in a squatting position. Stay away from tall structures and spread out if you are with a company. Wait until the lightning storm is over. What to do when having a brake failure? It is important to stay calm and alert during a brake failure. You also need to constantly and properly communicate with your passengers to ensure everyone's safety. Tell them to buckle up. Then, turn on the emergency lights and sound the horn to alert other drivers. Flicker your long-range lights too. Press the brake pedal hard to create pressure in the brake system. Then carefully downshift and put the gear stick into the L position. If your car has a mechanical gearbox, press the clutch pedal, then use manual brakes very slowly. This way, your vehicle will drift and begin to slow down. You may also turn right and left, changing lanes to better facilitate the reduction of speed of the vehicle. What to do when you choke and no one is with you? You heard of the Heimlich maneuver, which is an effective way of dislodging any foreign blockage of the windpipe. But if you are alone when you choke on, say, food or candy, simply position your fist with the thumbs facing the area above the navel and below the ribcage and lean over a table. Start pressing into the upper part of your abdomen using fast upward thrust. Do that repeatedly until the object pops out. Another effective method to do alone, yet even more painful, is to be on your elbows and knees and throw your arms forward and allow your stomach to fall flat on the ground. This would push air out and repeat this until the dislodged object is pushed out. What to do during an avalanche? If you got yourself caught by the gushing snow, try your best to stay on top of the snow as if you were swimming in water. Maintain this until the avalanche slows down. Once it slows down, you can try to grab onto something to carefully prop yourself up and stand up and call for help. Inspect yourself for any injuries. Make sure you are located somewhere where rescuers will find you easy. Using your hands, make a small air pocket in front of your face and calm down to slow down the breathing and not to run out of viable, warm air. What to do when locked in the car trunk? Sometimes this happens, and it's important to know what can be done to get back to safety. First, look for the taillight wires. Use something sharp in the trunk to cut one of the wires. Connect the cut ends intermittently to flash the taillights. That should call the attention of people who can help you. What about when the elevator car falls? Hundreds of accidents involving building elevator cars and gruesome videos caught the events on tape. To stay safe in a crashing elevator car, lie on your back with your head, neck, and chest protected by both of your arms. Put your right arm over your face and your left one over the back of your neck. You will suffer relatively less injuries in this position than when standing or squatting. How to survive stampedes. Stampedes occur when people start to panic and do not regard the safety of others. If you are alone and this happens, mimic the position boxers make when their arms to protect the ribcage as well as the vital organs. Give space instead of taking space, and keep a calm attitude during the stampede. Use all your strength to avoid getting pushed to the ground and stepped on. If you are with your family, have them walk ahead of you so you can see you're not missing anyone. Carry kids onto your shoulder to keep them safe. Next are whirlpools. These beasts aren't as common as the other ones we mentioned so far, but there's always a right way of escaping whirlpools. One thing to remember is not to fight the current, but to use it to catapult you to safety. Do not panic, as whirlpools weaken after a short while, so just keep yourself safe and without struggle. If you do get trapped by it, take a deep breath and wait for a chance to swim away. What if you fall off a cliff? You can minimize the injury by breaking your fall many times. Minor injuries are relatively better than major ones. Try to grab onto bush branches or rocks to resist the fall. Use anything you can to grab onto in order to break your fall by pinning it to the cliff. What if a pan caught on fire? Keep in mind that fire needs oxygen, so simply use the pan's lid until the pan cools. You can also use salt or baking soda to put the fire out. Be careful though. This calls for baking soda. Baking powder would do the opposite. It would feed the fire the way flour and other powders do. What to do to survive a tornado? We all know we need to stay in the basement and keep the door shut. If you don't have a basement, don't worry. You can go to the bathroom and sit in the bathtub. Use all the pillows in the house to protect you from any debris. If you don't have a bathtub, go to the spot in the house with the most walls, like a closet. Make sure you have your pillows with you, and you can use a shirt to prevent inhaling dust. What if you fell into a freezing lake? Say you fell through ice and into the freezing water. Don't grab onto the edge of the ice because you'll only break it further. Just stay close to the edge and try to float until you're floating horizontally on the water. Then carefully get yourself out of the water and into the edge. That way, your entire weight wouldn't be stressing the edge of the ice too much to the point of breaking. Be sure to call for first aid immediately once you're out of the freezing water. What to do to survive quicksand? Chances of falling into quicksand this year and the next may be low for you or anyone you know, but if you are trekking a rainforest, it's very likely you might get caught into one. First thing to do is to do your best to hang onto something and to keep your arms and head above the surface. Then, mimic the backstroke swimming motion by gently wiggling your legs and arms. This will increase the surface area and make it easier to pull your legs out. Lastly, how to stay safe during a house fire. Perhaps the most important safety tip we need to discuss is the one closest to home. If you're in the house and the house caught uncontrolled fire, try your best to not inhale any of the smoke. Most fire deaths result from toxic smoke inhalation. Stay low where smoke cannot go and crawl your way towards the fire exit or any viable exit. Cover your mouth and nose with a cloth and be cautious as you're heading your way out. There might be a chance you will encounter a dead end or falling debris and may have to get back to where you began. Do not bust open doors or windows. Stay calm in a place where rescue can come. These are just some of the things you can keep in mind to avoid tragedies and to steer yourself back to safety. Let your friends know about this video too. Like, share, and comment, and let us know which list you'd like to know next. Please subscribe, and as always, take care and see you in the next one.